It's actually been a really long time since I've made a video like this, where I just sit down and talk to you face to face. Usually you guys ask for a lot less of my face, so I usually give it to you, but you're gonna have to fuck off for today. Anyway, a lot of you guys have been asking for a story video. I know a lot of you in my stream will comment and, you know, bitch and piss and moan at me and just say, where are the story videos? You know, that's what we subscribed you for. Well, to be put simply, they're fucking gone and they're never coming back. No, but honestly, I do really want to bring them back to my channel because, I don't know, it's just kind of like sitting down and talking to hundreds of thousands of people. It's strange, yet kind of, I don't know, it's one of the videos that I really enjoy doing. And I know a lot of you guys like this type of video, so I mean, I don't know, I'll do it every so often if you want me to. Actually, leave a like and a comment if you genuinely enjoy videos like this. Like, I really do want to see if you guys, like them that much. Regardless, I've talked about this in my streams before, and a lot of you guys know about it, I mean, a little bit, but I've never really gone into detail with it. This is actually one of the first times I got in trouble in school, and I don't know, it was kind of iconic throughout my middle school, and they actually changed the rules in the handbook because of us. I have done so much stupid shit throughout my entire life, and I really do enjoy talking about it. Am I proud of all of it? No. No, I'm not, but a lot of it, yeah. Yeah, I am. So when I was in 7th grade, my group of friends was pretty much the entire 7th grade, like, guy class, because, I mean, there weren't that many of us. Okay, if you go to an American school, the class levels usually go by, you know, there's the advanced class up at the top, and then there's, you know, just the moderate classes, not very hard, and then there's classes for people like sore crude. People who are a little bit slow need some help, you know, I mean, it just goes by different levels. Well, my class of guys, it was like, I'd say 11 or 12 guys, and we, like, sat at the same lunch table, we did everything together, I mean, it was kind of gay. Looking back on it, I feel kind of gay. But honestly, I mean, looking back at it, I wouldn't trade it for anything, to be completely honest with you. But, you know, since it was just us all the time, and it was like 11, 12 guys, and then like 20 girls. So, I mean, we were pretty outnumbered. In terms of a house party, there was one dick per two chicks. So, I mean, it was really good. Like, it really was. But at the time, we weren't really trying to score. We were just trying to be as big of a dickhead as we possibly could. I mean, if you remember, like, being 13, 14 on Xbox, every little kid was just a belligerent fucking racist. I mean, all these kids were just like rude and obnoxious and loud. I mean, we were all assholes. Not saying that we were racist. I'm just saying, like, if you remember you know what I'm saying. But the group of girls in our class, they all also did everything together. You know, I mean, it was pretty much the boys versus the girls. It was a simpler time back then. I didn't have hundreds of thousands of people commenting on my weight every day. I also didn't do YouTube as a full-time job, nor did I stream. I wasn't really important either. Really shitty time in my life. No, but the girls were very sensitive. If you remember being, you know, younger, if you are younger in middle school right now, girls are pretty sensitive at this time. I mean, they're pretty sensitive for the most part, but then some of them are just kind of bitchy. And that's kind of what we were, because they were really preppy. And me, of course, I was, kind of a dick. All the time. You know, I had a lot of friends and everything, but my sarcastic sense of humor really got to people sometimes, and it was just a little bit too much. And I've always been kind of known for taking everything just a little bit too far. You can probably tell by my past occurrences on the internet, which, I mean, it really hasn't changed since I've been in middle school. So there was this girl, and I'm not gonna name her by name, even though we are friends now. She does watch my videos, so if you are watching this, I apologize. But she lived out in the country with her parents, and, you know, I'm from Indiana. Everyone, or a lot of the people from here, are kind of rednecks, hillbillies, blue collar, very, very white trash. I mean, Indiana is known most notoriously for corn and meth. And this chick, she lived with her parents and she did very country things. Her house was actually heated by a corn stove. So we thought it would be funny to everyone in our English class, we all had to write a story about, you know, this, we had to write like a fiction story, like a two-page essay. Every single one of us wrote about her corn stove and how fucking stupid it was. Like, if it was just me that did it, then it really wouldn't have been that bad. But the fact that it was everyone. And our English teacher, my 7th grade English teacher, actually was a feminist, funny enough. As you can see, we butted heads quite often. She actually proclaimed to us quite often that she was a feminist. That's where my hatred started, but we'll get into that later. So we're sitting there and we are just hysterically laughing when we turn all of our essays in at the end of class. Teacher comes in the next day and she is fucking furious. Because she went home and she read all of the essays and she's like, okay, this is targeted harassment. Like, this isn't just boys versus girls anymore. This is fucking bullying. At the time, we are like 13-year-old boys. I mean, we weren't thinking targeted harassment. We thought it was fucking funny. We all wrote about the same thing. And the fact that it was so stupid was, I mean, it was kind of the premise of it. I mean, it was just fucking retarded. So the teacher comes in and she shows the girl the essays. Like, what a bitch. Like, why are you gonna go out of your way to show the girl the essays of us making fun of her. And we didn't mean it as bullying. We meant it as like, oh shit, you know, I mean, this is gonna be funny. We're all gonna write about the same thing. We're all gonna get a good laugh out of it. No. No. Not at all. Like, the law enforcement got involved. So the girl starts fucking bawling in the middle of class. Like, not like, you know, shooting hoops and shit. No, like, she was like wailing, like she was in tears. And the feminist teacher goes, all right, and she brought three of the girls up to the front. She's like, I need you guys to make a list of who the biggest bullies are in your class, and we're gonna take them down to the office, and we're gonna have a conference with them, and I mean a few police officers and like the dean of students. So if you guys, for those of you who are new, you won't know this man, but my friend Matt, if you guys remember Matt is quite the character. He's been on my channel a few times. Guess whose names were at the very top of every single list? The two reoccurring names on every list, all three, and then the preceding list from all the other girls, because they found out that all the girls were kind of working in unison, be top two every single time, and it was terrible for both of us. Looking back on it, it was pretty fucking funny. At the time, I was scared for my life. So, you know, we didn't really think anything was gonna happen because a few days went by and I'm like, well, shit, you know, I mean, nothing's really going on. So we just carried on as our days as usual, bullying girls, shooting spitballs, playing Call of Duty until, you know, 1 a.m. During science class, we were making a structure and I decided to make mine a dick. While I was in the middle of making my, you know, we had molecules and like we had to put toothpicks and little balls and shit. While I'm putting my toothpick in my balls and making a dick, on the announcements comes our principal. And he gives us a little lecture as to how disappointed he is in the 7th grade boys class. We're like, oh fuck, you know, I mean, we got a little lecture, you know, he's gonna be angry for a few days. We're probably gonna have to, you know, do some in-school suspension, something like that. After the lecture, he proceeds to say, and down in the office, we're going to need to see, and reads a list of names figuratively this big, fucking scrolling through the entire 7th grade boys class, excluding three people. Of those three people, two of them were huge pussies, and one of them in high school turned out to be a transgender. Who'd have thought? So we go down to the office and we're marching in a single file line. Our hearts are fucking beating. I am terrified. Principal goes down there and we have a police officer in there. We have the chief of police in there. We have the dean of students, the principal, the school, like, who the fuck runs the school other than the principal? She, like, runs all the school, the fucking person, god damn it. Superintendent, fuck! We've got the superintendent in this bitch, and she is pissed. 7th grade teacher's down there with her fucking dyke haircut, like, and this is aside the point, but to my 7th grade English teacher, if you ever do end up watching this video, just know that I fucking hate you. Actually, no, I don't. I mean, thank you for allowing me to, you know, put me through so much bullshit to make videos like this. I do appreciate it. I'm still gonna need you to fuck off, though. I really can't stand you. So we get down there, and we're at this big-ass wooden table, you know, like a conference table in the conference room, and there's boys on all 12 seats of the conference table, as well as all around the room, and there was sitting room only. No, they actually made us sit down because, I mean, they wanted us to look up at them like they were God. So we're sitting there, and he goes, so, you know, you boys are a rowdy bunch. And I realize that girls sometimes don't get guy humor, but you guys really need to lay off. And I was like, oh, well, shit. You know, this isn't anything, you know? I mean, he's just gonna give us a little lecture. And I was like, all right, fuck yeah, fine. Well, what I didn't know is what he was about to pull up next. So let me give you a little backstory on this. Along with, you know, the stories that we wrote in our English class, I was wondering why the majority of the rest of the 7th grade boys class was down there. A few months prior to that, we as a collective class came up with a contract stating that this girl was the biggest bitch in the world and that she should just fuck off, you know, and just to get a little less detail because it was pretty gruesome. I mean, it was just fucking mean. Was. And if you do watch this video, you watch my videos. If you see this, I'm sorry. I do apologize. We made every guy in the 7th grade sign this contract saying that this girl was the biggest bitch and that she had thunder thighs. And which I have any room to talk. And you know, we had signatures after fucking signatures on this motherfucker. I mean, we had almost everyone in the 7th grade on this piece of paper. Actually, it was a few pieces of paper stapled together because there were so many fucking signatures. So he points to the police officer and he goes, officer, I'm not gonna omit his last name because he could possibly still arrest me for this. I don't know the contingencies of it. I'm just gonna keep clean. So he pulls out this contract and immediately my fucking heart stops.
Haha, Nuda, it was probably from all the McDonald's you eat. you fucking fat ass.
Well, it wasn't. It was actually just from pure shock. So he lays it on the table and then proceeds to lay the lists all on the table, and the top 5 on every list are circled. And then once we all started laughing, the top 10 of every list were circled because of how bad we were being, whilst in the presence of an officer and our principal. So the rest of the guys, we get this little speech about how we shouldn't be dickheads, you know, goes in one ear and out the other. I'm sitting there, my heart's fucking pounding. Everyone else leaves, and then it's me and then the rest of my, like, advanced class. I say advanced loosely because, you know, we were book smart, but we were complete fucking idiots. So the police officer then speaks up and says, you realize that we could send you to juvenile hall for sexual harassment, right? I'm like, what kind of fucking bullshit is that? I didn't fucking touch her, I just said that she was a hick and she did stupid shit. She dressed funny and she smelled bad and she did other 7th grade menial shit. Well, apparently when you attack the other gender, you know, since I have to say that because there's just so many genders now. In fact, there's 63. Apparently when you do that, you can't do that. Apparently when you do that, you can classify pretty much any crime you do as a sexual crime. And since there were so many girls that were just fed up with our shit, they decided that we should come down to the conference room on a weekly basis and take a kind of sexual misconduct class. Even though I did have to do that for the remainder of my 7th grade year, and, you know, when we went to 8th grade, something else happened along the lines of that. Honestly, I had a lot of fun. To be completely honest with you, during my sex ed classes, I had fun. Moral of the story, I know a lot of my fans are young and in middle school. Don't be a dick. And if you do, just be sure you have memorable moments of it for YouTube later in life. So that's the end of the video. Anyway, if you guys enjoyed the video, please be sure to leave a like and a comment, and if you're new,
subscribe.
Also, I'm gonna be pulling an all-nighter to try and fix my god-awful sleeping and upload schedule. After this video goes up, I'm gonna stream for a little bit, so if you wanna come chill on the stream, it'll be twitch.tv/nude. I'll put the link on the description right now. The link will also be in the description, as well all of my other social medias, and I'm gonna make another video after this, and hopefully tire myself out and die. That was a little too dark, huh? And to be completely honest with you guys, if you are young, you can get away with a lot of shit. I remember one time I got caught up in this double homicide case. Real shitstorm. Got completely out of it. My only excuse is the fact that I'm just a kid.